Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvendi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is lecture number 2 on the module 6 mass transfer. And the topic for today's discussion is diffusion in gases and isothermal evaporation of water. We recap from the first lecture of the mass transfer. We discussed the various mass transfer properties, mole fraction, mass fraction, concentration gradient, velocity, diffusion velocity, and Fick's law of diffusion. Now we discuss the diffusion of gases and isothermal evaporation of water. And at the end of this lecture, the student will be able to define or discuss the diffusion in gases, and they will be explained. Student will be able to explain the isothermal evaporation of water. Diffusion in gases. So we know there are many gas constituents in the gaseous mixer, and we take only two gas constituents. One is A and another one is B. We consider a mixer of gases with the two constituents A and B. The diffusion mass transfer process occurs in two ways. Gas A is diffusing into gas B, at the same time gas B is diffusing into gas A. That is what we discussed. We take a small beaker of water, you put some salt molecules or sugar molecules into the water. So the water molecule you take A, sugar molecule you take B, molecule B is moving in the low concentration area. The space created by the B, it is filled by the water molecule. So the molecules are moving in opposite direction with respect to the concentration gradient, concentration difference, and the sugar molecule diffusing into the water area, and the water molecule, they are diffusing into the gas area. Now, Fick's law of diffusion, we can write the Fick's law of diffusion for component A into component B for isothermal condition. So that is, temperature is constant in the mixer and the volume of the mixer is also constant. So, MA by A, diffusion rate, mass of diffusion of A with respect to area per unit area equal to minus DAB, diffusion of component A into B. So, D, diffusion coefficient for diffusion of component A to B, that is what DAB multiplied by molecular weight of A divided by RO into T into dPA by dx. So, the Fick's law of diffusion, dou CA by dou x is actually this is written in terms of pressure partial difference with respect to the distance x, direction x. Similarly, for isothermal diffusion of component B into component A may be written as MB equal to MB by A equal to minus DBA into MB by RO into T into DPB divided by DX. So, the partial pressure with respect to the direction x. Now, we discussed the equimolar counter diffusion. So, what is the meaning of equimolar counter diffusion? Each molecule of A is replaced by molecule of B and vice versa. So, molecule A is replaced by molecule B. Now, we have Na is the steady state molar diffusion rate of component A, and Nb is the steady state molar diffusion rate of component B. In that case, Na equal to minus DAB into A divided by RO into T into dPA by dx, and Nb equal to minus dBA into A divided by RO into T into dPB by dx. So, from the previous Fick's law equation, we are writing the Na in terms of Na, steady state molar diffusion rate of the component A. Now, we have the total pressure from the Dalton's law of partial pressure, total pressure P equal to PA plus PB. Differentiating this equation, dPA by dx plus dPB by dx equal to 0. So, or dPA by dx equal to minus of dPB by dx. Now, for each molecule, so equimolar counter diffusion, each molecule of A is replaced by each molecule of B. So, minus Na equal to Nb. And so, this equation, writing Na and Nb from the previous page, dAB into A by RO into T dPA by dx equal to minus dBA into A by RO into T dP by dx, and using the previous equation dPA by dx equal to minus dP by dx. So the dpa by dx minus of dp by dx is cancelled. A by ro into t, a by ro into t cancelled. Finally, dab equal to dba equal to d. So the meaning is diffusion for component A into component B may be written for the isothermal condition. So the diffusion coefficient, either the molecule A is diffusing into B or molecule B is diffusing into A, the diffusion coefficient is constant. That is what the meaning of the previous definition. And based on that, we can write the diffusion of component A into component B. We can write as MA by A equal to minus of D into MA by RO into T into dPA by dx. So this equation is called as a Stefan's equation, which we'll be using in future calculations. And now we take the isothermal evaporation of water into air. So the situation is, we have a small beaker or a test tube with the water at the bottom, and the air is moving. The air current is moving at the top of the test tube. So the entire space is filled with the atmospheric air, and the air is moving. So the diameter of the beaker is very small, and the air is moving. There is no air current, and the air is filled here with the atmospheric air, and the air is moving in the top of the vessel. And the water evaporates because using the temperature of the atmospheric air, water evaporates, and the water vapor, water molecules are moving here, and this is what the partial pressure, the profile of the partial pressure. So when you look at here, this side, the partial pressure of the air is very high. When you move towards the bottom of the vessel, the partial pressure of the air is decreasing. And when you take the partial pressure of water, so at the bottom of the vessel, the partial pressure of water is higher, and it is when you move in the upward direction, the partial pressure of water vapor is decreasing. So this profile indicates the partial pressure of water vapor and air. Now the assumption, so this is, the system is in isothermal condition and the total pressure remains constant. So the total pressure of the container and the temperature is constant. So the total pressure is atmospheric pressure. The system is steady state condition. So the property variation with respect to time, there is no change in the property with respect to time. Both the air and water behave as ideal gases. So the perfect gas equation PV equal to MRT is applicable for water vapor and the air. There is slight air movement over the top of the tank to remove the water vapor. So the water vapor is moving towards the top. As the water vapor reaches here, the water vapor will be removed by the air current at the top of the test tube or the vessel. There is a slight air movement over the top of the tank to remove the water vapor, which diffuses to that point. So air movement required to carry the diffused vapor does not alter the concentration profile of the air. So the profile, this line is not disturbed. The partial pressure line or the concentration profile line is not disturbed. So the air current is, air is moving only at the top of the vessel to remove the water vapor, which is reaching to the top of the vessel. And this is what the equation we discussed in the previous topic. So the mass of water vapor, it is given by minus D into A divided by RO into T, MW into DPW by DX into PT minus PW. And integrating this equation, you will get the entire equation is given like this. So the dA by RO into T, MW PT by X minus X2 minus X1 is the position difference. X1 is the position at the bottom of the test tube, X2 is the position at the top of the test tube. And this is the column, air column. You can take X2 minus X1 equal to length of the air column, and PT is the total pressure. And PW2 is the partial pressure of water vapor at the top of the vessel. PW1 is the partial pressure of water vapor at the bottom of the vessel at level 1, level 2. D is the diffusion coefficient. A is the cross-section of the tube or the vessel. MW is the molecular weight of air. PT is the total pressure, 1 atmosphere. And MW equal to 18 for water. And X2 minus X1 is the length of the column above the water, air column above the water. And this is the Stefan equation. Integrating the Stefan equation, we'll get this equation. And using this equation, we are going to solve problems. That is diffusion of water in isothermal diffusion of water into the air column. So using this, we'll be solving the problem. And these are all the books I referred for writing the, preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for further information. And I have written this book for hidden mass transfer. You can refer to it for additional explanation of the theory. If you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID, and you can also comment about the video. For if there is any comment, you can pass on the comment so that I will improve the video in future. Until then, thank you.